World War I, there was a great migration north by Southern African Americans. The war had caused a labor shortage in Northern industry. Citizens of foreign countries were returning to their native lands. From every southern town, migrants left by the hundreds to travel north.
I grew up the son of migrants. We were on our way, my mother and father were on their way north when I was born in Atlantic City, New Jersey. So at the very beginning of my understanding of communication with words, I was very much aware of this movement which took place, starting right after World War I and continuing on through the late 30s.
So I think it's appropriate to begin with the South when one talks about anything having to do with African-American culture. Yet it's interesting, here we have Jake Lawrence born in the North and growing up on the streets of Harlem. And at the same time, he has enough history built into him already to reflect on those beginnings of his parents, of his parents' parents, of other people who make this incredible journey.
I think what we have in Jacob Lawrence is that second generation of migrants who are beginning to look at the experiences of their parents and their relatives and saying, wait a minute, something important has happened here. Wait a minute, something that we need to capture is happening here. And his thought, I think his genius, is to recognize the importance of these events and to put them on canvas so we have them for the long term.
Thank you for joining us. My name is Dorothy Williams-Reed. I'm a teacher here at the Long Branch Middle School. And today I'd like to discuss some of the wonderful things that the AACC group is doing. AACC stands for African American Culture Club. We've been in existence for many years here at the middle school. This year, I thought it would be great to understand the Great Migration and how it affected American history. So my children learned about this through an art medium with the panels of Jacob Lawrence, a world-renowned American artist, was able to depict the Great Migration through 60 panels of art. What you're going to see in this presentation is our students, our Long Branch Middle School students, having created this and this kind of walk through history through a mixed media approach.
I had never seen a boll weevil. I'd never seen cotton. To this day, I don't think I've seen cotton. So I had to improvise. I had to improvise a bug or what I thought a boll weevil was. Maybe I looked it up. And to me, it was a, I liked the design. I liked the design element. So I was far removed from the culture I knew. But yet, I was very close to it through my mother and through her friends. So there's a paradox here, being close and yet far away, because my culture, although it's not southern, although it's northern, urban northern, is southern, because my background, my family's background, the friends of my family were all southern in culture, food, everything else.
I enjoyed working on this project because it was a way to express my creativity with art. I joined this club to learn more about it and what was the real meaning behind it. Through paint, he shared his family story and how they had to migrate to the north from south because they wanted to find better jobs and better things for their future.
The most impactful part of this project, I personally feel, is how the children had a vision of what they wanted and how it took so long for them to get to it. In terms of, we started it months ago and it kind of all came together. This was the launch of them understanding something in history that they really did not have any idea about. And the impact was that the children became more self-directed. They were anticipating, what do they do next? They had to work with teams and with their peers. And also when administration and our principals came in, they could actually share their knowledge with them, which as a teacher, I'm looking back and saying, wow, we did it. It's taken so many steps to get to this point. And just like art, it's your interpretation. So everyone got something different from the project. So as I look back in retrospect, it was a vision that I had that children could work together on a project and draw them closer together as a unit to create one project.